Welcome to The Advocate, a program that thrashes out all the topical issues of the day.
When you are in government, you don't see nothing wrong with whatever is happening. The moment you are out there, everything is wrong.
You can't even see many women now, and when they're there, they're not even really making a mark, and then they have an NYSE problem and this and that.
Really? Disastrous for a president to be unaware of the chief justice.
It's a ploy.
It could be a strategy.
That strategy was
a terrible
strategy. Because the buck stops at your table.
Whether it's that we don't look after our cities, and quite frankly, Nigeria is becoming a very ugly place.
When you are the only one feeding the people with this news, and there is nobody countering them, it becomes, you know, the news.
You're watching The Advocate on Plus TV Africa. Has it really been a couple of weeks? It's good to be back. I want to talk about diminished accolades. It was very recently the birthday anniversary of the late Stella Adadevoh, the Nigerian doctor who, by virtue of her action, averted the spread of Ebola at a critical time when it had not become such a scourge in neighboring countries. Every year at this time, many Nigerians call for her to be accorded a national award. I am one of such, but I only did so shortly after she died. But has she still been honored? Has she still not been honored? Why? Because she has been valiant, courageous, brave, and all without godfatherism. In our nation, awards go to those who make publicity out of acts that are ultimately self-serving. They are usually friends of government. Many are society butterflies who see awards as another feather to the cap, like chieftaincy titles. That a president is automatically given our highest national award is a complete farce. The award should be given for positive impact in society. An average performing president should be given a lower CADA award, if any at all. This is why I consider these awards as having been reduced in value. They are essentially for sale and do not lift one's perception of the awardee. All things being ideal, Adadevoh ought to receive a very senior award. She would become a serious role model for aspiring doctors and all other young ones. There could be a way that these awards are more democratically awarded in a nation beset by corruption in all areas. This is a tall order. The obvious action should be to scrap them entirely.
Honestly, I'm at that point where I think we should scrap them completely.
But I know it's not going to happen.
But my major problem with the way we do things in Nigeria, for instance, I know my mom won't be too happy, but I'm going to bring it up. Every single month or thereabouts, some church or another is giving her patronage, one award, one this. And, you know, I know it's not because, oh, they think one is so godly or one is so whatever. I think they know that it's the money that they're going to receive from this, from giving out these awards. These things really annoy me because they're pointless. There's several people that get these doctorates every single day. Meanwhile, you know that they did not get it the legitimate way. They've gone and paid someone just so that they can look the part. So in my opinion, if you have not done something worthy of that award, stop diminishing the value of these awards by giving them out. It is wrong. Now, a woman like Adadevoh that you mentioned, why till today? Why can't we just give her this award? Yeah. You know, I don't understand why we've been holding back. It's not for want of people campaigning about it. Why should anybody even have to campaign about it?
She was given an award.
Yeah, one small one that was hardly publicized. I saw it now.
Yeah, she was given a national honor, and that is so.
Yes, that the one. Yeah, I saw that.
What value was that one?
It's the same award that you're talking about, the national honors.
No, one very cheap award.
It was very quiet.
It's very cheap one.
No, exactly. It was one of those.
And
it was
very quiet. I didn't even hear.
Exactly. You didn't even hear about it.
How does scrapping awards
solve the problem?
No, what it is you're teaching young people now that awards can be bought. You're teaching them that if you don't buy your award, you might be a nobody. That means you buy being somebody, but you don't. Not normally. You would be somebody, and then you would get an award. So don't teach them that after a while you can just assume.
So maybe it's a process that we need to reform.
Absolutely.
To make it valuable as it's supposed to
be. He said democratic.
That's what I said. There could be a way.
I didn't know, let me use that word, I didn't know Obama was a professor of law until he exited office.
Oh, for real?
No, I want to say I didn't know. Let me just, even though I knew.
He wasn't brandishing. Yes, professor, Gordon Brown.
President.
Alleged chief doctor.
Yeah. You know, here
liberals, Gordon Brown. He's a PhD holder.
Yeah, but you wouldn't even know. Prime Minister.
Yeah. You hear, he was Mr. Gordon Brown, and that's what it was until he left, and then everybody
pastor,
said, okay.
Doctor, yeah. this, that, they'll nasty put PhD. Yeah. You know, so it's the same thing, MNS, DSS.
And so it stops having any meaning.
You know, so, and just recently, the governor of Lagos said, stop calling me His Excellency.
I was going to bring that up now. I was very happy.
Exactly. So here we like the accolades
and titles and awards.
Excellency.
And at the end of the day, it diminishes whatever intentions for giving those awards. And then when you now also give it to people that ordinarily do not deserve it, society where there are no mentorship. And so, people who deserve to be given an award would beg for it to get recognized.
And so,
when you do that, what you are telling the young ones is that, look, you really don't need to work hard to be recognized.
Just
those days, in the villages, once you are given a chieftaincy title, it means that you deserve
you
it.
You really deserve it, yeah.
But these days, you can just go and they look for one name. Ori Hedima,
somebody's
good things.
Yes.
And they give it to you.
And that's it.
I like the point Uche made that, you know, what I'm looking at is a social revolution. Mm. So this one, we can't just drop with government and sit back.
I'm coming now,
because this one lands on all our doorsteps. Mm. So from your mom, who is saying that she will go and collect, even though she herself may not have instigated it, somebody has to stand up and say, sorry, I won't accept this. Mm. Because it doesn't connect. Because someone told me a story. I mean, the guy who did the film, Daughters of Chibok, he's trying to raise money for the Chibok Society, and not much is coming. They've been abandoned. But he said he was present when the VP said, look, all you people who want to be putting big posters for my birthday, don't put big posters. Rather, I'm setting up a school in Maiduguri. Do you know, on the spot, they raise billions.
Mm.
One person raised the bulk of that because they link the award or whatever to what they can get from curry favor.
Mm.
So we need to start, you know, saying, no, we're not interested in all of this. We need to challenge these things openly. And when the person comes that you know is not worthy, don't stand with your head straight. Let them get the message that you bought this thing, but you haven't bought my recognition.
That's right.
A witness is in the witness box, and you say, so, mister, I say, no, please.
I'm not mister.
I'm doctor. I deserve it. Call me doctor.
We had a governor who called himself pharmacist.
You've seen this stuff?
Yes. There was a governor in this country who says pharmacist.
And I don't know that. Don't you see?
Farm builder.
My wife, her excellency, the first lady.
I was doing an invitation list the other day, and I realized how difficult this list was going to be because we really needed to get everybody's up-to-date title. And then I came across an ex-senator who didn't quite make it into the... But he still wants to answer honorable. So it was... Chief Honorable Doctor. And I looked at that and I said, are we really going to put all this down? I was told, yes, you have to put all of this down. So it really goes to show how important titles are to some people. But they don't mean anything.
To round up on this, also.
I'm not ready to round up yet.
Okay,
I have another thing.
I will say another thing. Take the legal profession, for example.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to court, you see that man with silk. Sits in front. You know, there's these threats. You're frightened as a junior lawyer, but if all of you wear suits and you sit down, you don't know who is a senior advocate or who's a, it puts you on the same pedestal.
Okay.
It is the same thing with all of these titles. Mm. And
correct.
So when you take away all of those titles,
then they're naked.
Yes, it becomes easy to assess. You know, government.
Oh.
It becomes easy also to relate with people who think they are up.
Yeah, because I think
but they won't.
I think
they won't
do that
because it's part of the deal. That's
correct.
The truth.
Yeah.
Even the car people bring to court. I knew a former senior advocate who used to go with a Rolls Royce to the court. They saw part of the impression.
To intimidate.
Yes.
But I would say, you know, and I believe I'm not the only one. I would trace the downfall of Nigeria to when we ditched meritocracy. Because a lot of people from the old regime, the old regime said, look, when they were in schools that you knew if you got into the school, you get, you know, you get a, what do you call this thing, when you get a scholarship. And you knew you merited it. The way he drove you to, that's why I love sports till tomorrow, no matter how terrible everything gets. Sports, you can't fake it hardly. You know, you're out there, you perform, you get the get the accolades. Okay. Yeah. And that's why people are driven in sports. That's why people still throng sports halls. You know, okay, there are ways of trying to
change. Same ways of
But you know, so and now politics has been taken advantage of. We need to get back to a merit-based society. And these awards are a key way of doing that.
Okay, well, now my matter has been addressed. It's with a sense of urgency that I'll be handing over the baton to Liberals to tackle the relatively significant issue of rice after the break.